Today we're going to take this beautiful black and white photo and bring back its color. Hello and welcome to an Affinity Revolution tutorial. If you'd like to follow along with the same photo I'm using today, I've included a download link in the description. To bring back this photo's color, we're going to use the Recolor Adjustment. So come to your adjustments and select Recolor. We're going to make this background blue, so come select some sort of a shade of blue, and I'm going to make it a little less saturated. That looks pretty good, so I'll exit out of that. And then we just want this blue applied to the background, not on top of the girl. So we're going to press B for our brush, and then paint in black to remove this blue from the girl. I'm going to make my brush bigger by pressing the bracket key underneath the equal sign on my keyboard, and then begin painting in black over her to remove the blue off of her. Now let's bring some color back into her hair. So come select another Recolor Adjustment, and this one make it some sort of a yellow or brown, somewhere around there, and a little less saturated. And then instead of painting in black to remove it from all of the rest of the picture, we're going to press Command I, which will invert our mask. So now it's applied to nothing right now. But if we paint in white, so I'll just flip these colors, we can bring that color back in. So I'm just going to paint in white over the top of her hair. And with this photo, I'm doing a pretty rough job just for the sake of speed, but you would definitely want to zoom in and be more careful with your painting. We're going to use the same technique to bring color back into her skin. So come press on the adjustments and select Recolor and pick some sort of a skin color. I think I'm going to make mine a desaturated orangey brown and then exit out of that and press Command I to invert my mask and then begin painting in white over her skin. If at any time you want to change the color, just come double click on your adjustment layer and then you can change the color. Now we're going to bring the color back into her lips. So same thing, come to the adjustments, Recolor, and make it a skin lip color. So I'm gonna drag it all the way over and then desaturate it. Exit out of that, press Command I, and then zoom in a little bit and paint on her lips with white paint. Now with her lips done, we're going to work on the eyes, and you should be getting the hang of this now. We're going to come to the adjustments, Recolor, and select an eye color. I'll make her have blue eyes, and desaturate that. Exit out of that, press Command I to invert the mask, and then begin painting over her eyes. As a finishing touch, we're going to add some white back into her eyes and down on her teeth. And we could use the Recolor Adjustment layer and just desaturate a color, but what I find that works better is to paint white on top of it. Let me show you what I mean. First, come click on New Pixel Layer, this icon down here, and then begin painting in white on top of her eyes and teeth. Right now, this obviously looks way too white, but if we change the blend mode from normal to soft light, you'll see that our eyes and teeth have been given a very nice shade of white. So now I'm going to zoom out by pressing Command 0 to see our finished product, And as you can see, we have just added the color back into this black and white photo. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more videos on Affinity Photo, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We come out with a new tutorial every Saturday. So hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.